Well, despite the heat, rain, shine, or heat, high school athletic teams still have to take to the fields for practice.
Boy, they sure do. That means they're also looking for ways to stay cool under the sun. 4029's Kyle Cabote went to Heritage High School in Rogers to find out what teams are doing right now to get their practice in, but beat the heat at the same time.
The sun is hardly up when the cross-country team at Rogers Heritage High School starts practice.
It's getting really hot, and we try and get them here at 7. They're out by 8:30 before it gets really bad.
The team starts early, not only to stay comfortable during practice, but also to stay healthy.
It's just too dangerous to be out in the midday for these kids to run 5, 6, 8 miles like we do.
Full-time football practice for Heritage started this Monday, and they also hit the field in the early morning.
To beat that this time of year, we usually have to start about 7 and be off the field by about 11:30, 12.
But sometimes that isn't enough.
We have a school board policy that we have to be inside if our wet bulb is over 84 degrees.
Rogers School started that policy years ago after a student athlete died during a football practice. Today, the football team moved to their indoor practice facility around 8:50 in the morning, hours before practice was supposed to end.
We do the same exact things. It's just a smaller area.
But even that practice field can overheat.
We'll hit in there, too, if it's too hot and humid. And then we just shut it down completely and we're done for the day.
Coaches say practice has been going well, and they hope they don't have to do that anytime soon. In Rogers, I'm Kyle Cabote, 4029 News.
And coaches for both the cross-country and the football teams want to remind us that heat stroke is always a risk during practice.
It sure is, and that's why they make sure to give their athletes lots of water breaks and to make sure that they stay hydrated.